And I think that is what, interestingly, has been recognised by the different voices that the eight writers on the Folio shortlist all show. Mm. All totally different, but all uniquely confident in their own voice and uniquely successful.
You've been listening to a Highbrow production. Highbrow, Folio Fiction Festival and the British Library. Interview with Sergio de la Pava, writer. Does being a lawyer make you feel like an outsider to the book world?
It's a little odd at first, right? I mean, you're right in terms of the outsider status, which I find useful as a writer, right? So this is kind of a bit of, it's a bit of a culture shock to be sitting around talking about just writing all the time, you know? It can be pleasant. You know, it's not something I get to do often, so it's pleasant. But at the same time, I think that I have this whole other life and this whole other pursuit that I place at least equal importance on. And this kind of casts into relief how critical that work is as well. So, you know, the more time I spend sitting around talking about literary theory and writing and publishing and things like that, the more it makes me realize I got to continue to do what I do in my other life.
How committed are you to your job as a public defender in the Manhattan courts?
Well, you know, speaking purely from my legal career standpoint, it was really the only kind of work I ever wanted to do. It's really the reason I acquired my law license was to do what we call in the United States an indigent defense, representing people who are charged with a crime, who the state is trying to incarcerate, and who can't afford to hire their own lawyers. So it's certainly, I wouldn't call it a lifelong passion, but let's say a career-long passion. It was the reason in many ways that I went to law school, and it's the only kind of work I've ever done with my legal degree. And I mean, now with a book like A Naked Singularity, the two things seamlessly fit together, right? And I get to pursue my other passion while bringing in this other pursuit that I'm still dedicated to. You know, as my writing progresses, there'll probably be a little bit less interplay between the two things. And I think with my second novel, there's a lot less, obviously.
Do you get inspiration from your experiences in the court system?